I just wanted to give an update of where to find the filtering menu now that things have changed around a bit in GeoSoft with the update. And so what you do here is you go to Project, and you go down here to Manage Menus. And I hope I'll be able to find it, although I think I've got it clicked on already, so it's fine. Oh, thank heavens I do. Okay, so what you will probably see is something that looks like this. So Standard Menus up at the top, and down at the bottom, Extensions. So when you click on the plus, I'm also going to just minimize mine so it will look like what yours looks like. You'll see this long list of different options. Okay, and so let's just go through some of the things. So this, if you click on the plus, 2D filtering, this is where you're going to find like the reduced to pole and the vertical derivative and the analytic signal. Depth to basement, if you've got it, there's some nice depth estimates. Geophysics, this is IGRF, I think on databases. So if you want to correct your data, let's close it. And then this advanced profiling is the GeoSys profiling, so it's 2D modeling. But I mean, the main thing we're going to focus on now is this 2D filtering. So you click it and you click OK. And it should load in this menu over here. And then if you want to do reduced to pole, you're going to go to the first one here, click on map filtering. You're going to choose, your input grid. So I'm just trying to look here if this is a worthwhile thing to filter. So let's go here. I'm going to click this Western one. Then your output one, you can type whatever you want. I like to choose the same grid as up here, and then on the end, just add an RTP so I know what I've done to it. This con file, I know in previous videos, so I do know there's a way that you create it, and I've now forgotten how to do it. You can just create a text file, so literally open up a text file here, save it somewhere that you'll be able to find it again. So on the desktop, I'll just call it GeoSoft, like that. And then if you go to where you save that file, so I'm going to the desktop here. Let's find it. Did I save it on the desktop is the question. No, where did I save it? Sorry, let's do that again. Okay, file, save as. I did. I think I'm going crazy. Let's search by, there we are. Okay, so I've searched by names. Here's my GeoSoft file. So you go to it, you click on it again so that it's editable, and you edit the extension to .con and click Enter. It's going to say to you it's going to become unstable, and that's absolutely fine. Click Yes. Okay, so it's on my desktop now. So let's just double check that this works. So I'm going back to GeoSoft. So if I go here to find this con file that I've just created, I find it on the desktop. Here's my con file. You can see it's loaded. I'm leaving that the same. Click on the More button. It's not the More button. Click on the Edit Filter. And this is where you'll be able to choose a bunch of different filters. Okay, and it's quite nice. You see here the spectrum on the left, and you see the original grid over here. So I'm going to go down, and I want to do Reduce to Pole. Okay. And you can see down here, it's showing you a preview of the filtered results. And so you would have to know the survey date. And in all honesty, I can't remember the survey date. I'll have to go look. So let me just use this one here. Once you've typed in the survey date, if you click on Calculate, it should give you this inclination and declination. I'm going to leave this amplitude correction as a default. You're welcome to go look up on it, about it. And so I'm going to click OK. And so just so you know, you can come back here and use derivative. So you could do X, Y, or Z derivative. You could come back. There's low-pass filters and high-pass filters. You can see here's your high-pass filter, low-pass filter. Tons of different things you can do here. Butterworth, directional derivative. Lots of filters to come and play around with. Also reduce to equator if your survey area is closer to the equator. And that's actually a good point because my survey area is Angola, so I probably should come back and do reduce to equator. Let's do reduce to pole for now. Again, I do not have the correct survey date, but I'm just going to click OK and click OK again. And yeah, you should have a result there.